That's one 32-ounce bag of tater tots. Now you're gonna add 1 pound of fresh chicken. This has been cut into cubes. We're gonna top that with some bacon pieces. I'm gonna use about half of this bag. And what else goes with chicken and bacon? Ranch dressing. We're gonna use this packet of ranch. And you're gonna dump the entire thing on top. And now we need to top this with some cheese. There's cheese. Some shredded cheese on the top shelf.
Get that. Here we go. Fiesta blend.
Perfect.
Perfect.
And this is the reduced fat cheese, so that makes it even a little bit healthier. We've got our healthy chicken. But I would love to hear from y'all. Do you like to have the pre-shredded cheese like this, or would you rather get a fresh block and spread your own? Let me know in the comments. Now, once we've got the cheese on there, I've used about a cup there. We're gonna now stir this up, just getting everything mixed up. You wanna get that dressing, the dressing packet, and the cheese, and the chicken all spread out. There we go, I think we got that mixed up pretty good.
Right.
Now, I would like to hear from y'all, when it comes to fresh chicken, do you wash the chicken? Is that something that you do? I know there's a big, Kyle's laughing because he has a story to tell you about when he washed the chicken last time.
Well, tell him the story then. See, you just said wash the chicken. What do you do when you wash the chicken? You tell the man to wash the chicken. You do I use? You use soap to wash chicken. And apparently, you're not supposed to use soap to wash chicken.
You're not supposed to
use
soap.
What do you do? You're not washing it, you're rinsing a chicken.
Do not use soap to wash your chicken. All right, now next you're gonna add a 10-ounce can of this cheddar cheese soup. This is the healthy request kind. That means it's got lower calories, lower fat, and less sodium. We're gonna take a 1/4 cup of milk. I'm using the skim milk. And then we're just gonna combine that just enough so that we can have a nice mixture to pour over the top of my dress and our casserole. Now you take your cheese mixture, pour that all over the top. Doesn't that look good?
That looks delicious.
Wow. Now, I know a lot of y'all are always asking, can we do recipes without cheese? Y'all can update, modify these recipes however you prefer. You don't have to follow it exact. If you'd rather use, the fresh potatoes that you made yourself, you can do that. If you'd rather use fresh made bacon, you can do that. If you want to omit the cheese, you can. Your heart's desire is the endless limit of what we can do with this. Get that all mixed up. All right, look at that, looks good. We got everything all mixed up. Now, y'all let me know in the comments what you would do differently at this. If you wanna modify it, you can. You can use the fresh chicken, you can use the fresh bacon. It's up to you. But we are going to be cooking this on high for 2 hours, or if you have more time, do it on low for 4 hours, and then it's gonna be taste test time.
Yummy.
All right, it's been cooking about 2 hours, and I'm ready to taste test this. Now, you can't go wrong with the combination of potatoes, chicken, bacon, and cheese, and of course, ranch. That's all the good stuff. And you're probably wondering how that turned out. And look at that, nice and steamy. Now, our potatoes are almost like a hash brown consistency, but look at that chicken. We've got some nicely cooked chicken. I think this is good. Now, if you wanted to sprinkle more cheese on right before serving, so you've really got a nice layer on top, you can do that as well.
All right.
But I think this is gonna be
good. I'm excited, let's try this out. What are we calling this one?
This is chicken, bacon, potato casserole. Chicken, bacon, ranch, potato casserole.
You're just saying all the ingredients.
Well, that's kind of what it is, right?
Okay.
All right, I've got this first bite with potato and chicken and bacon.
How is it?
You're actually gonna love this.
Ooh, okay.
So chicken is fully cooked. That was perfect. And the way that you're able to get away with only 2 hours is because it's really small bites of chicken. It's a good combination, right?
I was worried because I wasn't, the hash browns things are not...
they're not crispy like tater tots normally are, but that's okay.
It's still good though.
It's still really good.
It's like potatoes, so...
Now, some of y'all are not a fan of the condensed soups. You don't have to use it. You could just use fresh grated cheese if you wanted to.
Oh, they would miss out though. That's
a good flavor.
It's a good flavor,
it really coats it nicely. I think that this is a winner. I'm definitely gonna think that you are too. You want one more bite?
Sure.
It's good, right? It needs pepper. That's what it's missing. Pepper. Don't forget the pepper.